All right, welcome back to Prestige. We're at the car shop today. Today we just want to take a minute, a little bit of tech advice on how to properly burp a cooling system. So, all right, first we're gonna start off with what we do here at Prestige and understand not everybody has like a vacuum fill kit like this. Snap-on makes a really, really nice one, all right? But what we do is we start with this system. And the reason being, before this jug is put on here, we put the system under a vacuum. First thing that does is kind of, more or less, it's going to verify and validate that we don't have really any leaks, at least under vacuum. It doesn't test it under pressure, but if you left a hose clamp loose, maybe you left a pipe plug out of it, something of that nature, it will immediately tell you, hey, there's something wrong because it won't hold a vacuum. The second thing that's supposed to do is evacuate all the air out of the engine itself, the casting, and the entire cooling system. Then, when it's under a vacuum, there's a separate fill hose that you'll open and it'll suck the 50-50 coolant into the engine, okay? Theoretically, this should be an air-free fill, if you will. From our experience with aftermarket engine blocks, maybe it's casting design, that doesn't always work. So, as I mentioned, we do the vacuum fill for starters. Now, for those of you that don't have it, that's fine. We can do the old school way and fill it up manually. In this case, you'll see we've got a funnel on here. Okay, now this is just another, there's a bunch of adapters. You can get these on Amazon. It's very easy to find. They call it a Lyle funnel. They make them in yellow, clear, whatever. What happens is you've got this adapter and it's got a seal on the bottom. This is going to sit down in the neck of the radiator and the cap will go on and obviously tighten it down so we're sealed. Then the funnel, as you see here, will sit down in here, giving us a fill point that's obviously higher than anything else in the engine compartment. That is pretty key here as well. All right, so once we've filled it up, normally we fill it nice and slow as well, okay? Just to alleviate causing any air pockets while it's going in there. Once we've filled it, we know it's leak-free, we leave the level of the funnel roughly halfway. At this point, you're gonna fire the car up, okay? What I suggest is you can use, you know, like a shop rag and lay it over top of this thing and still to where you can kind of view it from the side. You don't need to do that right away, or they give you a lid you can put on there and just leave it off to the side. I'll tell you why you need that later. So for this demonstration, I don't want to run the engine, but we would let that come up to operating temperature. What you're going to see is bubbles forming and popping up in this funnel. Once that thermostat opens, obviously if there's any air or steam pockets, and steam is the worst, but if there's air, you're going to see some disruption. You're going to see a lot of action in that funnel. That's where the rag or the cap comes in handy, because if there's a steam pocket in there, that steam pocket is basically boiling. And when it's trying to come out of there, it may come and squirt out of here and make a mess, okay? And certain engine blocks and manufacturers are worse than others. So that's what's handy about just throwing that on there just to try to alleviate the mess. That's also why we recommend the $15 funnel, because most people aren't going to let it percolate and let it get the air pockets out because it makes a mess. You get it all over a nice $1,000, $2,000 radiator and a brand new car. Nobody wants to do that. So these are very handy for that. So at that point, the thermostat's open. All the action has slowed down. Maybe it's dropped in level. We top it off and this thing should run 180, 190 all day long with it uncapped like this. During this time, this is an excellent opportunity, because generally when the motor's warming up, it's gonna take a little bit before that thermostat opens. You know, you can check if it was an automatic transmission, check transmission fluid, looking under the car, make sure there's no leaks. Our oil pressure's good. You can do some checks and balances while this is happening, okay? Once that thermostat opened, as I said, and the action has stopped and the funnel is basically still, The next phase of that is to reach, whether it's a, if it's drive-by-wire, you'll have to get somebody in the car to open the throttle pedal with a mechanical throttle body. Just slowly rev that thing up to like 3,000 to 4,000 RPM, but make sure when you come off of that 4,000 RPM, bring it back gently to idle. Because sometimes if you just close them blades, whatever goes on with that water pump, it'll squirt a bunch of water out of here. So, but the key to that, we're revving it up to try to put water pressure into the system using the water pump to squeeze out any air pockets in the back of the motor, all right? So once that's done, we're satisfied. There's a neat little piece here. You can just take and push this into the funnel. That's going to make sure that it doesn't leak out. We can take a simple little rag, and if we slowly see, we'll pull that off, and we've still got our coolant. Obviously, you can put the cap on it so we don't spill it. All right, so as I was saying, you can lift the funnel off. One of the things we do here, and this doesn't always, isn't really possible for every car shop. At that point, you could technically cap it and go drive it per se. A lot of times, we're not in that much of a hurry. The car's been a long-term project. I would actually leave the radiator cap off overnight, let the cooling system condense, and you're gonna notice the level drop a little bit. In the morning, you can come in and just top it off the rest of the way to the top of the radiator and cap it. Then, we need to make sure that we've got an overflow tank or expansion tank. The overflow tank, usually 16 ounces or larger. And at that point, I would go ahead and fill this to the top. This particular tube would be the tube that would evacuate it down onto the ground. So if I fill this up maybe about a quarter inch below the height of this tube, then what will happen, we've got a fully purged, full cooling system. Whenever it heats up again, it's going to expand. And when it expands, it will put coolant in that overflow tank. Whatever it doesn't need is going to drain on the ground. You can put basically a catch can or basin underneath it. But at this point, now we have the working level of how much coolant needs to be in that system, and it's perfectly air-free. So for more in-depth information on the cooling system packages that we provide, along with our Ultimate Turnkey package, stay tuned. There's another video that gets in-depth detail of what we use and why we use it. Thanks for watching.